I think this is good publicity for Sacha Baron Cohen for his show, but it comes at the expense of maybe a tasteless move.
I think there's a line, and he crossed it. He's bringing U.S. veterans into this.
But have you seen the lines that this guy has really crossed before?
Yeah.
This is definitely
he's
one
edgy.
Of them, but this is who he is, right?
I mean, I guess that's just the line that comedians have to cross all the time. It's, is this too far? Am I going too far? But just getting in a wheelchair and acting as that role just for a joke, I mean, I think it's too much. And imagine if you were a U.S. vet watching.
Oh, no question.
Mm-hmm. You know, I just...
There's usually an argument for crossing a line in comedy if you're making a broader point that's kind of, you know, commenting on the culture or something that's, you know, kind of intellectual in a sense. But I really don't see Sacha Baron Cohen as a guy that's doing that. He's crossing a line to cross a line and, you know, blow this thing up into some funny type of stuff. I think this is really wrong. I think impersonating veterans is just something you don't do. So for me, I see that. I'm like, you know, I don't agree with everything with Sarah Palin, but I'm with her on this one.
Yeah, I can agree with you guys more in what you're saying here, but knowing the person as a I don't want to say fan, but as a viewer who's mm-hmm. seen Sacha Baron Cohen and what he does, he came out of the gates back in the late 90s, early 2000s, and really pushed the envelope, whether it was running around naked, whether saying a really crazy stuff to people that you're like, whoa, almost to the point where it's uncomfortable.
Right.
Now you give him 15 years later in a world that has become more sensitive and privy to situations that they need to be more sensitive to. I think he saw this as like, okay, this is the perfect time to truly make people uncomfortable, and this is where I can truly make a splash for those people who are anti-sensitivity to issues that deserve being sensitive to. And I'm really going to pursue that crowd and really placate to them. And I think that's what he's doing here.
That's a good
point. I think he knows exactly what he's doing. I think he knows exactly how wrong it is, but he knows it's going to draw
eyeballs.
But even
though you say that's who he is, you just said it's 15 years later. You know, it's a more sensitive time. I don't know if he should be teetering so much in these, like,
it might be timely now with this debate we're having about civility in politics and who can be civil and who has to be civil and who doesn't. Maybe he is actually striking at the right
100%, because you know how many people want to see Sarah Palin get burned by somebody and see her duped? A lot of people. So there's an audience for it. And there's a huge audience that's saying the logical thing that we're all saying here is he crossed the line with people that give you the liberty to do this by putting their lives on the line and maybe lost a limb or disabled because of it.
Right. I think you could fix it if he goes through with the donation. I think that's a good thing.
I don't think he's going to listen to Sarah Palin, but we'll see. All right, so remember back when you were a kid, recess was probably your favorite time of the day.
Oh, yeah.
If you had friends, B. Pope, unfortunately, did not.
Excuse me, I was the captain picking people on teams.
Oh, there you go.
Excuse me.
What they're saying now is it might be time to bring back playtime into your life because research shows that playtime, it's as beneficial both mentally and physically for adults as it is for kids. This approach is applicable for life both in and outside of work hours. Are you guys subscribing to this belief that you got to have fun and enjoy recess?
Unsubscribe. I am unsubscribed.
Wow, really?
This is so stupid. Everyone's there to work, do their work.
It's not just work.
It's work.
The story's not just work, though. It's about life in general.
Oh, well.
But within work hours, too.
Okay. So I like the idea of, like, having a league with your coworkers, mm-hmm. you know, like having a volleyball league or a kickball league. You know, that's
fine. That
fun.
Qualifies.
That's fun.
That's
sports.
The recess thing.
Yeah. But if it's during work hours, no. Like, I'm at my work hours to work and be as efficient as possible as I can in my 8 hours. And I'm not spending.
She knows the boss.
No, I'm not kidding. Like, even if it's just to go get lunch sometimes, I'd rather eat them. Like, I'm a hard worker, and I like to get my work done and leave
the day feeling good.
And then I could go have
recess. Chris is the one where you come in for the job interview, they're like, tell me one negative thing about you. My negative thing is that I just work too hard. Like, come on, Krista. Like, everybody likes to have a little bit of fun. And in the article, it talked about some of the things that maybe qualify as recess. Mm-hmm. Maybe have a Jenga set in your office that you play solo by yourself.
I'm not
maybe have colorful pens in there that are something
fun.
That stuff builds morale and team building. I love icebreakers as an example. You know, icebreaker games, you get to know people in the workplace, you get to work with them better because of that. I don't think you need a whole, like, kickball game and, you know, an old school recess type of style thing.
See, like, I like the leagues. No, you guys, you're no.
She's the Stanley of the office right now.
But I don't want to do it during my work hours. If it's after work, for sure, I'm down. Let's go. Go to a bar, play kickball, whatever. I'm there.
But she's all about
her work. I don't really truly know where Krista stands on this one. She's all across the board. B-Pope, I'm not sure where you are either.